I am explaining the ninth chapter, The Bond of Love, which is written by Kenneth Anderson. Now, important question, the bond. Bond means relation, real chemistry of love. Can there be love and friendship between human beings and wild animals? Yes, there can be. So, in this story, there is a nice, fascinating, attractive account of one orphaned sloth bear that was rescued by the author. Now, there are many ideas given. By chance, one small baby sloth bear was brought by the author. And friendship happened between author's wife and baby sloth bear. It is nice chapter to be read. It is written as a personal experience of the author. When it was brought by the author, by chance, because of one accident, then it was a baby. It was a child at that time. When the bear grew, it was sent to a zoo. Then it is given ultimately. But in between, nice story is given. When it was brought by the author, by chance, nice friendship started happening between author's wife. And she named it Bruno, looked after it like her own child. It's nicely described here or there. Slowly, slowly, Bruno started eating everything and he never say no to anything. Bruno was like a naughty child. Then two incidents are also given. One day Bruno ate some of the poison but was recovered by an immediate treatment. Once one more thing happened. It drank one oil, but it didn't have any bad effect on its body. So many ideas are given here or there. She changed her name when it grew in its size. It needed at that time open and more space to live. Actually, he was very fond of author's wife, means Bruno, which was given this name earlier. Name was changed from Bruno to Baba. On advice of author's friend, he was sent to the Mysore Zoo. This separation became really inconsolable for author's wife. She couldn't live without that. She sent many letters to the zoo authorities. Then it is given, they started inquiring about Baba. On getting knowledge that Baba was eating nothing, she visited Baba at Mysore Zoo. Bruno recognized her and he started jumping with joy because he was very happy. She did not want to be separated from him and requested the superintendent to send Baba back. He consented and Baba was brought back. At home, special arrangements were made for it because it grew in size and it couldn't be accommodated in their home. At home, what was done, special idea is given. A 20 feet long and 15 feet wide island was made for him. A wooden box was kept for his comfortable sleep. Then nice ideas are given. Some toys were also kept with Bruno, with which he used to play earlier in their home. So, the author's wife used to spend hours sitting with him and they started living very, very happily. Though it was a tough journey, but both were happy in each other's company. So, it is a nice chapter to explain how one wild animal can get proper love from one human being. So, it is the meaning of the bond of love. Now, important questions. Third part. On two occasions, Bruno ate or drank something that should not be eaten or drunk. What happened to him on these two occasions? Bruno ate barium carbonate, which was put to kill the rats and mice. So, paralysis set into the extent that he was not able to stand on his feet. So he was taken to doctor and ultimately he was cured by him. Once he drank 1 gallon of old engine oil, but it had no ill effects whatever. Earlier, for the first occasion when he took barium carbonate, he was given injections, but on the second occasion nothing happened, rather he became himself okay. Now, second part, was Bruno a loving and a playful pet? Why then did he have to be sent away? Yes, he was a loving and playful pet, but he was naughty too. The bear became very much attached to narrator's wife, narrator's 2 Alsatian dogs and the children of the tenant. But when he grew elder, then what happened? Its size became many times double when he was earlier when he entered in their home. Then her name was also changed to Baba. So he was getting too big to be kept at home. That's why he was sent to a zoo. Now, third question. How was the problem of what to do with Bruno finally solved? Bruno was not feeling happy when he was away from the narrator's family, especially from narrator's wife. He was getting weak every day and there was almost same position. The narrator's wife was not interested to take anything and she was every time complaining. So same happened with that sloth bear. So narrator's wife went to Mysore to meet Bruno. After seeing his pitiable condition, she decided to get him back home. They made many arrangements, many requests for Bruno. Then ultimately it was taken home and they created a special facility at their home. So it was kept in the home. One more question was there in writing part. Pets have unique care and handling requirements and should only be kept by those with the commitment to understand and meet their needs. So give your arguments. Yes, I think we should write in favor. Pets every time are very important for humans. So they become the member of families. So animals do have same emotions and sentiments. They play the role of a father, mother, brother sometimes, but they need to be tackled very properly, carefully. So I think that pets give us happiness and every time help us in gaining confidence in the difficult situations. These pets need special care and love. So we feel ourselves fortunate if we get one special chance to be with them. But it is not very easy to take care of all the animals properly if we keep them as pets. So we should be very, very clear. Each and every pet should be given nice facility, abundant love and affection. Only then we are doing proper treatment towards them. Otherwise, it should be guilt with us why we are keeping them as pets. They can make us real humane too.